Hi, Manna family. Every winter we have the trees in our yard pruned. It's pretty obvious we have a lot of pruning that needs to be done here every year. Pruning is essential for the health and production of fruit-bearing plants. Pruning is also essential for the health of God's people. Jesus talked about pruning and fruit-bearing in John 15. He said in John 15, verse 1, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes it that it may bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, so neither can you unless you abide in me. The whole point of a vineyard is to produce a good crop of high quality grapes. Proper pruning is necessary for the vine to produce quality grapes. Pruning removes about 90% of the previous year's woody growth. If the branches are not pruned back, they will produce more grape clusters than the vine can actually ripen into maturity. So pruning gets rid of non-essentials like excess wood and leaves so that all of the vine's energy can be put into growing what's essential, which are grapes. God the Father is the one who does the pruning in the lives of his people because he wants us to bear more fruit. You know, our culture wastes a great deal of time and treasure on the trivial, on the non-eternal. Pruning is when God cuts away the non-essentials from our lives so that we can focus our energies on producing spiritual fruit that will last forever in heaven. God prunes us using his word, his Holy Spirit, and circumstances. That's what he does spiritual surgery on our lives. Hebrews 4:12 tells us that the word of God is living and active and sharper than any two-edged sword, a really effective pruning shears. Pruning is painful, but it's an act of love. Hebrews 4:6 tells us, for whom the Lord loves, he disciplines and scourges every son whom he receives. Hebrews 10:12 tells us that God disciplines us for our good, that we might share his holiness. Just like our Heavenly Father, we discipline our own children. We train them to do what is right because we love them. We want them to grow up and mature into godly adults. Spiritual fruit is growing more like Jesus. It's experiencing more fruit of the Spirit in our lives, and it's making disciples for Jesus. Spiritual maturity and making disciples does not come from our own efforts. It's not a question of good works. It comes from abiding in the vine, which is Jesus. Jesus said, I am the vine and you are the branches. The branches, that's us, we must remain connected to the vine for life to flow from the vine through the branches in order to produce fruit. A disconnected branch is a dead branch which can't produce any fruit. Abiding in Christ means remaining intimately connected with Jesus by obeying what he says. In John 15:10, Jesus said, if you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love. So our job is to remain connected to Christ by obeying what he says. It's God's prerogative to prune from our lives whatever hinders our relationship with Jesus. This is a wonderful season for us to grow in spiritual maturity and make disciples for Jesus. Remember, God designed us to do life together.